Welcome to Emboldened Movement. My name is Chelsea, and I will be the yoga instructor leading you through this restorative practice. So, before you get on your mat, I encourage you to have either a yoga bolster, one or two blocks. If you don't have those things, large books and a couple of pillows will do the trick. So once you have your things, I'll meet you on your mat. Welcome to your mat. To begin, let's grab our two blocks and a bolster or some pillows if you have them. What I'm going to have you do is stack one block on the tall side, one block on the lower side, and then bring your bolster or pillows right on top. Extend your legs out nice and wide, bringing the inner thighs towards the bolster. Deep inhale in, lengthen through the spine, relax the shoulders, and then begin to fold yourself forward, bringing the head to one side and arms just next to the bolster. Completely relax your feet, your face. Just pause here and breathe. With each inhale, filling the lower belly, and each exhale, just releasing through the nose. And if your mind ever wanders, just allow yourself to come back to this moment on your mat. Back to the inhales and the exhales. Invite you whenever you're ready just to turn the direction of your head so you're getting the same amount of stretch on both sides of the neck.
Deep inhale in. Exhale, begin to walk the hands back towards the thighs, slowly pressing yourself up.
From here, remove the bolster. Just to the side of the mat, we'll use it again. Remove the blocks, keeping one close by. So from here, bring the bottoms of the feet to the mat, bringing your sit bones close, and then just walk the body down. We're setting up for a variation of bridge pose. So deep inhale in, exhale with the hips rise, and then grab the block, placing the block right underneath the sit bones. So I recommend using a higher setting, but please use whatever feels good for your body. We are going to be here for a few moments. So really ground through the feet, all four corners. Letting your back relax. Resting the shoulders on the mat, palms on the floor. Breathe nice and deep. Inhaling into the lower stomach and releasing the exhale through the nose.
Few more moments here. If your mind has wandered, just allow yourself to come back into this pose, noticing where the hands meet the mat, where the feet are holding you. And as you're ready, just begin to bring the toes, walking them up towards the sit bones, just a little bit closer. Come on to the tippy toes. Let the hips rise, removing the block, bringing it to the side of the body. And then very, very slowly bring the spine back to the mat, one vertebrae at a time. Pausing here for a moment. Noticing sensation. And as you're ready, just turn to the side of the body here. And allow yourself to use your hand just to make your way back. From here, we're going to set up a similar way with the bolster. So starting here on the tall part of the block, followed by the second shortest setting. Bringing the bolster close. This time, bring right leg in, right to the edge of the bolster as you extend left leg behind you. Nice and tall with the spine, deep inhale in, and as you exhale, just begin to lay over the bolster. Hands come to the side, and just face
your face, or your gaze rather, have your gaze over your right shoulder. It might feel good here to place a block underneath the left hip if you notice you're kind of falling towards the right side of the body. But wherever you are, just allow yourself to really come into a position of rest here. Oftentimes in restorative yoga, when we're holding poses for a long time, it becomes difficult in the mind to stay where you are. I encourage you though, just to allow the mind to wander, and as thoughts come in, just recognize them, acknowledge them, and let them pass. Always bringing yourself back to the breath, back to this moment. Just being curious about whatever sensations are happening in the body. Being curious about whatever emotions are coming up in the body. And just allow yourself to really release into this posture of rest. Deep inhale in, walk the hands towards the knee and the foot. Gently let yourself rise. Left leg is going to come forward. Release right leg back. So setting up for a reclined pigeon on the opposite side. Left leg comes forward, right leg extends back. Sitting yourself up. Elongate the spine, nice and tall. And slowly release the body over the bolster. Again, a blanket or block might feel good under the left hip if you notice that you're kind of falling over to the left side. Gaze over your left shoulder. Inhale in, begin to walk the hands towards the knee and the foot, pressing yourself up.
Right leg can come back towards the front of the body, extending both legs in front of you just for a moment. And then as you're ready, removing the bolster, bringing it to the side, removing the blocks. So from here, I'm going to have you grab the blocks. Similar setup that we've used for this whole class. Set tall side, set second to short side. We're going to bring the bolster right on top. But this time, what we're going to do is we're going to draw the left foot back. So you're folding that left leg. Extend the right leg out, and then just allow yourself to recline back onto the bolster, hands coming to the sides of the body. Breathing nice and deep here. Really, it doesn't matter too much where the foot is, it's wherever you're starting to feel that stretch right in the hip flexor. Palms can be up. Eyes can be open or closed to you, whatever feels best for you. And then just allow yourself to come back into the breath, the inhales and the exhales. If it feels good here for you and if it's in your practice, I encourage you to inhale deep, maybe for four or so seconds, hold for 3 or 4 seconds, and then exhale for 4 or 5 seconds. Holding the exhale on the out for 3 seconds, and then start again with the inhale. Inhale for 4 seconds. Hold for 3, exhale for 5, hold for 3, inhale again, hold, exhale, hold. Number of seconds doesn't matter too much. Just allow yourself to breathe, using that as a guide, but knowing that you can always change it if it doesn't serve you. And as you're ready, just bring the palms just to the sides of the sit bones. Slowly allowing yourself to roll up. Lengthening through left leg. And then bending right leg behind you, bringing the foot towards the sit bones. Once again, allowing your spine to come back to the bolster. Hands to the sides of the body, palms facing up. I invite you to once again come into that breath, inhaling for a count of four, pausing for a count of three, exhaling for a count of five, and holding the breath out for a count of three. Always with an option to modify if that doesn't feel good for you. Wherever you are, just notice your inhales and your exhales. Once again, as you're ready, just bring the hands to the sides of the body, close to the sit bones. Take a deep inhale in, and slowly allow the spine just to roll up off the bolster. extending the legs in front of you. Turning to remove bolster.
Bringing it to the side of the mat.
You can use the bolster, whatever pillows you're using for this next exercise, this next pose, just to bring it over the leg, or you might prefer a block, or maybe you don't need anything at all, and that's absolutely fine. So from here, lay on your back. Inhale, right knee in, allowing yourself just to clasp the lower leg right under the knee. Giving yourself a little squeeze here. Deep inhale in, releasing the leg. Bring the arms to the sides of the body, palm facing up, as your right leg just folds over the left side of the body. So this is where you might rest your leg on the bolster or block. Arms can stay at the sides of the body, and then gaze over the right hand. Really allowing the body to release here. Deep inhale in.
Bring right leg back in towards the chest, clasping
right underneath the knee here as you draw that knee under the chest one more time. And then on your next exhale, release the right leg down to the mat.
Moving whatever block or bolster you used to the right side of the body.
Inhale, left knee in, clasping right underneath that joint. Bringing left knee in towards the chest. Deep inhale in, release. Letting the left leg come over the right side of the body. Placing it on whatever block or bolster that you're using. Arms come to the sides of your body like a T. Gaze over left hand.
Deep inhale in. As you exhale, just bring that left leg back over to the left side of the body, drawing the knee in, giving yourself one more squeeze in towards the chest. Deep inhale in. Exhale, release left leg to meet right. Bring the hands to the sides of the body, palms facing up, coming into your shavasana. So as always, you can focus in on the breath here. Or I invite you just to bring your awareness back to any sounds that are going on in the room that you're in. Any sounds that you hear around you. Just allow yourself to notice those things. As you just take a moment to relax, allowing the body to integrate all the movement, all the stretching, and all the sensation we've created in it over this last practice. Deep inhale in. On your next exhale, just bend the left arm, bringing the hand towards the head. Just allow yourself to turn towards the left side just for a moment. Allow yourself to press up through the right hand, come into a seated position. Maybe you stack legs here, maybe you cross over at the ankles, wherever you are. Just allow yourself to rest when you get comfortable. Lengthen through the spine, deep inhale in. Exhale, release. Two more inhales and exhales. Deep inhale in. Exhale, release. Last time, inhale. Exhale, release. Hands come to heart center. Thank you for practicing with us today. Namaste.